Hey everyone, thanks for joining me on this video. In this video, I wanted to talk about GPTs, more specifically, those GPTs you find on ChatGPT. There's a ton of them out there, so I wanted to kind of narrow it down and find for you the ones that I think do the best job for text-to-image graphics. So whether you're using this for print-on-demand, for t-shirts, or other things, maybe you just want to create graphics with ChatGPT and AI, these are some of the best ones that I've found. I've tested a lot of them, and I'm gonna show you what the product is or what the output is for these. I'm gonna use the same prompt for all of these, and you're gonna see how they've changed a little bit. So if you want like a kawaii thing, there's GPTs for that. If you want another certain style, there's GPTs for that. So that's what this video is gonna be. I'm gonna go into ChatGPT right now and show you a bunch of these GPTs and what the outputs are. All right, so here I am on chatgpt.com. You can see ChatGPT 4.0, and this is important. So we're gonna see what GPTs we're using. So depending on what the GPT you're using, you're gonna see it here in the top left. So the first one we're gonna do as a base is just the regular ChatGPT 4.0. And the way to find the new GPTs is right here, GPT. So we're gonna go through that, but let me show you what I did and what prompt I use just in the basic ChatGPT 4.0. All right, so this is the prompt that I started with. Create a graphic with a raccoon wearing sunglasses with a blue star spangled scarf and holding a hot dog in one hand and a USA flag in another hand. And I didn't put like anything about do this in this certain style. So that's kind of the thing that I wanted to do, is not put that in and just find the style that's that the GPT, in this case ChatGPT, is gonna do naturally without adding anything. So I did say a graphic. That I think that's the only thing I said. I didn't say cartoon or anything, but most of them understood that it's cartoon. So here it is. Really nice. I'm gonna make it bigger here. I think it does a fantastic job of it. Just not using any GPTs, just a GPT 4.0. I think the style is great. I think it will work on t-shirts. I think it will work on stickers. It's classic. I don't think you need anything other than this, but if you want, I'm gonna show you some of the other ones, but this is really good. But if you want a different style than this, I think going into the GPTs can be a way to do that without actually typing in, do this in this certain style, do this in this certain style. We know ChatGPT can do that. We've seen the Ghibli things and all of that, but I wanted to show you some of the GPTs. So I'm gonna scroll up here and show you GPTs. And when you go in here, one of the things that I did and why I wanted to do this video is I could type in t-shirt like this, and it gives a lot of different ones here. So I thought, man, there's so many that create t-shirts, but be warned that some of these are not image generators. Some of these are just to help you with ideas for t-shirts, not necessarily. So not necessarily graphics for t-shirts. So I'm gonna show you which ones I like. First, before going there, you can also scroll down, and ChatGPT kind of puts these in groups, and you can see Dolly, transform your ideas into amazing images. So this section is kind of the text to image part of what we're looking for, and a lot of these are really good. The one I wanna show you first is this one right here, Image Generator. This was one of the better ones out of all these. And I'm gonna show you what came out of this one and how it looks compared to the GPT-4 that we just did. All right, so you can see right here, I'm using Image Generator. You can see right there. And then this is the same prompt that I put in here. And this one kind of went back and forth, so this is pretty cool. This said, instead of just giving me the image, it asked me a question. Is this raccoon image for a social media post, presentation, merchandise, or just for fun? Let me know. I want to tailor the style, which is kind of nice. And then I said it's for a t-shirt design. And then I said a vintage cartoon style would be cool. So this time I actually asked him what style to do it in. And you can see it kind of matched the GPT-4 style that we saw earlier. But then it gave me some hints, and this is why I really like this image generator one. It said, do you wanna add backgrounds? Do you want a red, white scarf? And then like, it kind of prompted me to be like even more like to make my t-shirt design better, right? So I said, well, can you do it in another style? And then it asked me, what kind of style did you want? So it says, Sure. What alternative style would you like? Something more realistic, cute, chibi, cartoon book style? And I thought, wow, chibi would be cool. I haven't tried that. So there it is. And it's kind of like the kawaii style, but it came out really good. And then it prompted me again, which is what I really like. So I really like this image generator. And then I just said, well, maybe add some words and stuff. You can see, how about adding the words red, white, and Pharaoh on the bottom and fill the white space, and it did it. And it looked, it took this and then it added that, which is really nice. And then it continued. So it kind of just prompted me on what new things to do. And I think that's a really cool use for AI and image generator. Instead of just stopping at a graphic, it kept prompting me and asking me for more and more things to make my design better and better. And I think this is a really good for the future of AI. I think more AI image generators should do this, because a lot of times we don't know what we want, but then it kind of prompts us to know what we want or gives us ideas on what to do. And I think this turned out, this is one of my favorites. So, of all the ones that I made with this prompt, and I think it turned out really good. And this right here could just be a t-shirt design. I could just knock out the white part and it's already ready to go. Well, it has to be upscaled, but once it's the right size, I think it looks like a good sticker or t-shirt design. So good job, image generator. One of my favorites. That's why I wanted to show you this one first. One of my favorites in the GPTs. The next one that I really liked is this one here in the DALL-E 3 group, is this consistent character GPT, and I'll show you why. Let me go and show you what I did with the prompt and what it did. So here's the consistent character. I used the same prompt right there, and this is what it came up with. Look at that style. I just think that's a real good cartoon style. It might be really hard to put on a t-shirt and cut this out, but the hot dog looks real. This looks like something from Pixar almost, which is really cool. So if you like this style and you want to use it for something else, I think it one of the nicest looking ones. Again, I didn't put in cartoon style, it just did it in this style, which is really neat. And but I wanted to see the feet, and so the next thing I put is, can you show the full body and put it on a black background? And it did it. So here's a full body kind of cartoon style. I kind of wish it was animated, maybe I can put that in, but it looks like something in that, you know, Pixar style, like looks like real fur kind of thing, and but still has that cartoony look. So one of my favorite looking styles on here, not necessarily a t-shirt design, but look at that. That looks really cool. So I'm excited to try this one. And if you want to try this GPT, I think the output's going to be really, really cool. So back to the GPTs, I'm going to show you some of the ones that I did with the t-shirt. So I'm typing in t-shirt here, and AI t-shirt designer, this one right here, is a fun one that I liked within the t-shirt ones. There are only a couple of them, so I'm going to show you a couple of them in this t-shirt search that I did, and some of the results. All right, so this is AI t-shirt designer. You can see right there, I use the same prompt. And again, this one is another one that asked me more questions. Instead of just giving me the design, it asked more questions. I said black background, no text, just the graphic. For some reason, it removed the background. I don't know why it did that. So I asked it to not do that. And after a few things back and forth saying, actually, there is no background, it thought it had a black background. So I said, do it again. And this is what it did. And I think it turned out pretty good. This is a nice style. I like this. It really looks like the original ChatGPT 4 style, but the drawing is great. The fur looks great. It's like a nice illustration. So I think this is another one that turned out pretty good. Just make sure that it has the black background, or if you want the transparent background, I guess it can do that too. So pretty neat. So another one, I highly recommend this one for t-shirt design. I'm sure it can do other styles, but by default, it just does this nice looking design style, and I think it did a good job. I don't see anything wrong with it. The other one that I really like is the top one, no surprise here on the search t-shirt, is t-shirt design. So I'm gonna click on it. This is what it looks like, t-shirt design. by John Fraser, and I'll show you what this one looks like. So here we are, t-shirt design. Here's the prompt, and instead of giving me extra things or hints or anything, it just created the image and that's it. So if you like this, if you like this style, very similar to the other one that we just saw, but I think this does a good job as well. Pretty quick it came out, and I like how I did the stars here and the flag and the hot dog. So I wanted to do this prompt because I wanted to see how it drew other things and can it understand that it needs to hold things in it. It did a fantastic job. This would look great on a t-shirt. The last two that I want to share with you are two that I use a lot, and that is StickerWiz and Kawaii Creator. So the way to find StickerWiz, if you don't have it like I do on the side here, you can just type it in, StickerWiz. Like that, it should be the first one. That's it right there. I know there's a whole bunch and they look exactly the same, but the one you want is the one by ChatGPT. So I don't know who made, I guess this person made almost the exact same thing and it's getting a lot of traction, but you want to get the one by ChatGPT. So just click on here and you can see right there, and then you can start the chat. So this is what StickerWiz did, and this is why I like it. So looking up here, you can see StickerWiz, you can see the prompt that I did, and look at that. It's such a nice style. It's so different than the other ones where it had the kind of the jaggy edges. This one is really straight lines, which I love. Just a nice cartoony style. Things just work out really nicely. Even the mouth is smiling and everything. It's just a happy way to do it. It's just, I like the simplified version of StickerWiz and the big bold black lines, and not to mention the white around it, because it's supposed to be used for a sticker, and it can, it looks like a sticker, but I like to use it for t-shirts and just remove the white background here. So this is one that I actually use to make a t-shirt. Here's the t-shirt that I made with it, and I think it turned out great. So I love using StickerWiz, and so you can use it too. It's not just my GPT, it's one that you can find in the store. Again, go and type in StickerWiz and use the one made by ChatGPT. The last one I want to share with you is Kawaii Creator. This one right here, I made it. You can see by Detour Shirts. I'm not sure if you actually can find it in GPTs. Let's try it. I'm going to do Kawaii Creator. And oh, there it is. I am the first one. So Kawaii Creator by Detour Shirts. So that's the one you want. That's pretty cool. So just search the GPTs and let me show you how this one turned out. It turned out pretty cool too. So you can see Kawaii Creator up here, same prompt, and this is what it looks like. I think it turned out great. Again, simple lines, but it's more kawaii because the head's a lot bigger and kind of just even more simple than the one that we saw with the cartoon. So one's a cartoon, StickerWiz does great cartoons, but if you want it even more kawaii, you can see this right here. So usually kawaii stuff is facing forward and kind of see that, not all the time, but this is a really good representation of kawaii stuff, wearing the glasses. And again, I like this because I can vectorize these as well as the other one because of the simple lines. And then if I want to change the color of something like here, like these glasses, once it's vectorized, I can change that really easily. So I think it did a great job too. So one of my favorites, the StickerWiz as well as Kawaii Creator, I use them a lot. So there you go. Those are my favorite GPTs for creating graphics for t-shirt designs. But as you can see, you could probably use that for anything. If you want to use any text to image AI, I think GPTs or those GPTs in ChatGPT are really great. Now, if you want to use an AI app that does all of it, like the text and the graphics, you notice I just did graphics here. I think Mystic does a great job with putting it all together with text and graphics together. I recently did a Mystic video, their newest upgrade 2.0. I'll put that video right here so you can try that as well if you're interested in another place to try text to image AI art. I think that one does really well, especially for t-shirts, posters, and those kinds of things. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.